Hello student, so we have completed all the topics of chemistry paper second. So last topic that is remain is the environmental chemistry, right? So all organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry topic we already have completed. This is the last topic, and keep in mind this topic is not mentioned in the state board syllabus. So Maharashtra state board syllabus chemistry paper second, here they have not given the environmental chemistry. It indicates environmental chemistry topic is not in the Maharashtra state board syllabus. This is also not in the IIT advanced syllabus. Okay, this environmental chemistry topic is only given in the syllabus of NEET and JEE main. Okay, so there will be the question in NEET as well as JEE main exam. There will not be the question on MST CET exam, because MST CET exam is going to conduct by the Maharashtra state government. So Maharashtra state board syllabus, there is no environmental chemistry topic in the 11th class. So hence question will not be in the MST CET pattern exam. Okay, so this environmental chemistry is also not in the IIT advanced syllabus. This environmental chemistry topic is included in NEET syllabus and JEE main syllabus. So you are going to appear both these exams, so therefore our duty is to take this topic. Okay, this is a very easy topic. So this environmental chemistry you have studied in 11th class, that in 10th class also, in 9th class also, isn't it? So this world is facing a big problem due to the wastage of the plastics, due to the fossil resins, due to the fossil fuels, and as well as due to the you can say different phenomena of radioactivity, right? So that is the nuclear waste. Okay, so due to all these things and due to the development of this modern world, we have now colorful world. Before this modern era, that is the medieval era, there was not a colorful world. So after the 16th century, so this due to the industrial revolution that has been taken place in 16th and 17th century. So it has been started in the 16th century. Okay, so after the 16th century, when the industrialization revolution of industries takes place, and due to that many gases has been spread over the world, spread over this atmosphere, isn't it? And due to this nuclear waste, many pollutant has been spreaded. Similarly, so this environmental chemistry has been important to know the every person. So what is to be pollutant and why should I save the nature? It is very necessary to save the nature, otherwise many viruses, you are now we are facing this problem due to the different viruses also now, due to this coronavirus 19 pandemic. So this is also one of the virus due to the environmental pollutions also. So that pollution due to the human beings activity as well as due to the natural activity also, isn't it? Okay, so this environmental chemistry topic is kept to pretend for every student, isn't it? Okay, so preaching for the every student. Okay, so every student, every human being should know what are the effect of different pollutant. So for that purpose this topic has been included in the NEET syllabus as well as in JEE main syllabus. Okay, so now this environmental chemistry topic, we have to study the environmental pollutions, right? Okay, now let us see what is the environmental pollution. So this is the direct or indirect undesirable changes in our surrounding as a result of human activities that have harmful effects on plants, animals and human beings. So we do the different activities. We have to do the different activities. So now in the modern world, this modern era, different colorful world, so the industrial revolution has been taken place. So this is a information technology era. So therefore we do the different human activities, and due to that activity the different waste material, different gases has been expelled in the atmosphere, and that causes the environment, environmental pollution. Okay, so now not only the human activities, natural activities also expel the different pollutant in the atmosphere. So you know that this lightning of strikes, okay, so this lightning of strike produces the nitrous oxide gas. Okay, we cannot control that nitrous oxide gas actually. So this is the natural phenomena. So that is the lightning of strike is the natural phenomena. Due to the lightning of strike, nitrogen dioxide, that is NO2, and nitrous oxide gases has been expelled in the air. That also causes the pollution. What I mean to say, is that not only the natural activity, but also the not only the human activity, but also the natural activity produces the different pollutant that pollute our environment. So now, what is meant by pollutant? So a substance which causes the pollution is known as pollutant. So what are the substances? You know that we daily use the single disposable plastics also. So that is one of the substance, isn't it? So many time we use this DDT also, okay, this dichloro, diphenyl, trichloro, ethane. So the DDT we use, so the DDT is one of the substance, and that DDT again causes the different diseases. So this DDT is the carcinogenic substance. So therefore a substance which causes pollution is known as pollutant. Okay, a substance which causes pollution is known as pollutant. What are the example? So example is DDT. So this is one of the substance. So this DDT causes the different diseases also. So see, this DDT is a carcinogenic substance. So if the excessive amount of DDT is used, then the cancer may grow in the body of the human beings. So this is the pollutant. So this DDT is one of the pollutant. So as you know that in the sea, so what happened, we have different type of feces. So that feces get polluted due to the this what we can say, nuclear waste. Okay, if the nuclear waste is released and they are released into the sea water, what will happen? The different type of cancer cell may be developed on the feces. So hence feces get polluted due to the this nuclear waste. So there may be the question that arises in NEET exam. What is the question? Which of the following pollutant causes the cancer to the fishes? So what is the pollutant? So that is the nuclear waste. This nuclear waste is the pollutant, and this nuclear waste causes the cancer to the fishes. Okay, so fish get polluted due to the nuclear waste. So you know that in Maharashtra region, you know that in the Madban area, that is in the Jaitapur, we have built one plant, that is the Areva company of this France give us the thorium, or we have given the uranium, isn't it? Uranium from the Areva company of France. Thorium is already present in our country. So we have export this uranium from the France, and we have built up one industry, that is the nuclear power industry, that is in the Jaitapur, that is Ratnagiri district. So there you see that much more amount of nuclear waste has been released, and that Ratnagiri area is a sea level area, sea coasty area. So therefore, whatever the nuclear waste is there, radiations of this uranium, thorium, all these nuclear waste is released into the sea and sea water. So therefore, different fishes get polluted due to this nuclear waste. Okay. So now you know that pollutant may be solid, liquid, or gaseous substances. Keep in mind, so pollutant may be solid, may be liquid, may be gaseous. Okay, so therefore, this, as I told you, that this due to the lightning strike, nitrogen dioxide gas is released in the atmosphere. So that is the pollutant. So pollutant may be solid, that is plastic, one of the carry bag plastic, this is the solid pollutant. Then gaseous pollutant, nitrogen dioxide. So liquid pollutant, so this DDT is also a liquid, dichloro, diphenyl, trichloroethane. What is the long form of DDT? Dichloro, diphenyl, trichloroethane, right? Okay, that is the DDT, this is the liquid substance, right? So therefore, pollutant may be solid, pollutant may be liquid, or pollutant may be gaseous. So keep in mind, they are present in a greater concentration than in the natural substances. See, these solid, liquid, and gases, pollutant, are present in a greater concentration than in a natural substance and produced due to human activity or due to natural happenings. See, this is a very big problem for universe, not for only India, that due to the human activities, due to the natural happenings, the greater concentration of pollutant is present in the air, that is, than that of the natural substances, right? Okay, so this is the very important thing, that is, you can say that pollutant can be fast degradable or non-degradable, in which rapidly break down by the natural process. For example, so this is the discarded vegetables. So this discarded vegetable easily get degraded. Degraded means they can be cut into the simpler form. Degradation, what is the degradation? Complex compound is converted into the very, very simple substances. That is called as the degradation. So hence, this vegetables, so you know that daily we use the different type of cauliflowers, then we use the brinjal. Okay, so whatever the material which is to be discarded, that is easily get degraded in the nature, whereas the other material, that is the pollutant which is produced due to the different human activities or natural happenings, so they cannot be rapidly break down, they cannot be degraded very easily, they can live for 10 years or the 15 years also. So therefore, that process is very slow. So hence, there are many this artificial pollutant like the DDT or plastic. So they cannot be degraded very easily within 1 year or 2 years. They require near about 10 years. After 10 years, they will get degraded. So this much time is required to get degraded for all these material, that is the pollutants. Okay, so you know that as in this topic we have to see the different pollutions. So pollutant also in the water, so therefore water get pollutant, water get polluted. Pollutant may be released in the air, so therefore air get polluted, so hence air pollution. Then many pest pesticides. So for to destroy the pest which is present in the crop, we use the pesticides. Okay, so that pesticides we use, so that also causes the pollutant to the soil. Soil get polluted, so therefore soil pollution, air pollution, water pollution, so all these are the pollutions due to the different type of pollutant. So you know that our farmers generally use the pesticides. Why? To destroy the pest which is present on the different leaves, different plants or different crops. Okay, so different crops or different plants is getting affected by the pest. So to destroy that, to inhibit that, to kill that pest, we use the pesticides. So there is one suggestion given by the different scientists that once you use the pesticides, you don't go in that farm within 2 days. Why? Because the pesticides, whatever we use, that get converted into the vapor form, and if we inhale that vapor, if we inhale that vapor, what will happen? That is also a cancerogenic substance. We get irritate, isn't it? So irritation may takes place, asthma may takes place, bronchitis may takes place. So therefore, there may be the cause of bronchitis, there may be the cause of asthma, there may be the cause of irritation of ears. So hence, once we use the pesticides in the farm, we cannot go there at least 2 days. After 2 days, it will get contaminated or in the air, so therefore that cannot be affect on the human being. Okay, so now there are the different type of pollutions, to atmospheric pollution, stratospheric pollutions, isn't it? What is mean by the atmospheric pollution? So in the atmospheric pollution, we have to see the two things. What are that? First is the atmospheric pollution, that is the troposphere, and second is the stratosphere. In the atmospheric pollution, we have to study the troposphere and the stratosphere. Okay, so now what is the, where the troposphere region we generally observe? So generally from the sea level, that is up to the height 10 kilometer from the sea level. From the sea level, if we go upwards, so up to 10 kilometer from the sea level, up to 10 kilometer, this is the troposphere. What is the region of troposphere? So troposphere region, the height of 10 kilometer from the sea level. This is very important. Question may be asked in this point. Okay, so what is the region of troposphere? The region of troposphere is the height of 10 kilometer from the sea level, right? Okay, this should be underlined, this should be very important. So what is the height of the troposphere? What is the height of the troposphere? The height of the troposphere is, the height of troposphere is 10 kilometer from the sea level. Okay, so in this troposphere, what happened? Turbulent dusty ozone containing air, much water vapors and clouds. Okay, so keep in mind, in the troposphere, human being live as well as the animals also live. Okay, plants, animals, human being, all these are covered in this region, that is the troposphere. We live in the troposphere, animals live in the troposphere, and then plants are alive in the troposphere region. Okay, so therefore turbulent dusty ozone containing air, that is much water vapors. So keep in mind that there is a much percentage of water vapor in the troposphere. Okay, so therefore water vapors are much more contaminated in this sphere, that is the troposphere, right? Okay, keep in mind. Whereas, so in the stratosphere, what is the difference between the troposphere and the stratosphere? So this is the lowest region of the atmosphere. Troposphere is the lowest region of the atmosphere, that is 10 kilometer from the sea level. So this is the region of the troposphere. So what is much more present in the troposphere? Water vapors are more present in the troposphere. So this is very important. So their question may be asked, in which of the following sphere the percentage of water vapor is much more? troposphere, stratosphere, lithosphere and ozone layer, like this. So therefore, we are in the troposphere, right? Okay, so this should be keep in mind. Okay, so hence another question maybe arises, what is the region of the troposphere? So the region of the troposphere is the 10 kilometer from the sea level, right? Okay, so this is regarding the troposphere. Now next is the stratosphere, right? So we have to study the stratosphere pollution. So this is the atmospheric pollution. Atmospheric pollution are up to type, that is the tropospheric pollution and stratospheric pollution. Okay, so now, so this above the troposphere there is a stratosphere, right? Above the troposphere there is a stratosphere. So in between the 10 and 15 kilometer above the sea level, okay, so up to 10 kilometer from the sea level, troposphere. After 10 to 15 kilometer there is a stratosphere. Okay, so therefore above the troposphere, between 10 and 15 kilometer above sea level, okay, so who is present? Stratosphere is present. Okay, right. Okay, it contains the dinitrogen, that is the N2. It contains the dinitrogen. It contains the dioxygen, O2. Right? Dinitrogen indicate the nitrogen gas. Dioxygen indicate the O2 gas. Right? Okay. So it contains the dinitrogen, it contains the dioxygen, ozone, and a little water vapor. Okay. So question may be asked. In this stratosphere, that is, what is the region of stratosphere? The region of stratosphere is between 10 and 15 kilometer from the sea level, right? From sea level up to 10 kilometer, troposphere. After troposphere, 10 kilometer to 15 kilometer, who is present? Stratosphere is present. So above the troposphere, between 10 and 15 kilometer above sea level, who is present? Stratosphere present. What does the stratosphere generally contains? It contains the N2 gas and O2 gas. Keep in mind. Okay, it contains the N2 gas and O2 gas. So this is very important. Dinitrogen and dioxygen and ozone is also present in the stratosphere. So keep in mind O3. Okay, so N2, O2 and O3. Dinitrogen, dioxygen and ozone is present in the stratosphere. Keep in mind. Okay, so this stratosphere contains a very much less amount of water vapor, that is 0.4%. Keep in mind. Okay, so very less amount of water vapor are present in the stratosphere, right? Okay, so you differ here. Troposphere contains the much more amount of water vapors. Water vapors are much more percentage present in the this troposphere, whereas stratosphere contains the very less amount of water vapors. So that the 0.4% of these water vapors, right? Okay, so this H2O vapors present in a very small quantity, in which that is the stratosphere. Okay, so we can compare this troposphere and this stratosphere, right? Okay, so what is the troposphere? So troposphere contain what? That is the dusty material. Troposphere contain generally the dusty ozone containing the air, much water vapor and clouds, right? Okay, so this dusty ozone containing air, water vapor much more amount and clouds are present in the troposphere. Out of that, these water vapors are in a much more amount in the troposphere. What is present in the stratosphere? Dinitrogen, dioxygen, then ozone layer is also present in the stratosphere, and that is the little amount of oxygen, that is 0.4% of water vapors are there. So as you know that ozone layer is present in the stratosphere, and you know very well that different type of gases is getting depleted to the ozone. Okay, so this ozone layer. Okay, so ozone layer is present in the stratosphere. So hence this ozone layer is depleted, that is depleted, that means it get degraded. Okay, ozone layer get damaged. Okay, depletion of ozone, depletion of ozone layer. Okay, so depletion of ozone layer takes place. Why? Due to the global warming, you know that is the carbon dioxide gas. Okay, so due to the vapors of the carbon dioxide gas, so the ozone layer get depleted, and if the ozone layer get depleted, the adverse effect is much more on the human being, so that is on the skin, so cancer cell may be developed, and different type of skin diseases is occurred due to the depletion of the ozone layer. So hence stratosphere must be maintained very peacefully in the environment. Once we disturb this stratosphere, that is ozone layer get depleted due to the carbon dioxide gas, carbon monoxide gas, or you can say this due to the nitrogen oxide gas, NO2 gas, or sulfur dioxide gases. So hence, due to the generally global warming, that is the carbon dioxide gas generally depleted the ozone layer, and due to that ultraviolet rays are directly get strike on the skin of the human being. Okay, due to the depletion of the ozone layer, ultraviolet rays are directly striking on the skin of the human being, and due to that striking of the ultraviolet rays, the skin get damaged, as well as cancerous cell may be developed in the body, different type of diseases of the skin may be takes place. Okay, so to overcome this, stratosphere must be kept very clean. So this is very important. So stratosphere must remain clean, otherwise what are the adverse effect on the human being, that I have said you. Okay, so this is regarding the atmospheric pollution, that is the troposphere and the stratosphere. So the other part of this environmental pollution we will see in the next video. I hope that you can understand this very easily. So this topic is a very small topic. May questions are very directly questions, easily questions are asked in the exam. What are that questions asked on this part? I will take these questions in the next video. Thank you.